Hello students, welcome to the class on third semester complementary mathematics paper. In this class we discuss section 9.2 motion on a curve. In section 9.1 we have studied that the vector function in 3 space has the form r of t is equal to f of t, g of t, h of t, that can be written as f of t I plus g of t j plus h of t k, and its first derivative is given by r dash of t is equal to f dash of t I plus g dash of t j plus h dash of t k, and the second derivative is given by r double dash of t is equal to f double dash of t I plus g double dash of t j plus h double dash of t k. Now consider a particle that moves along a curve C whose position vector at time t is given by the vector function r of t is equal to f of t I plus g of t j plus h of t k. Then the velocity of that moving particle is given by v of t is equal to rate of change of position vector, that is dr by dt, that is r dash of t. And since r of t is equal to f of t I plus g of t j plus h of t k, we have r dash of t is equal to f dash of t I plus g dash of t j plus h dash of t k. Similarly, the rate of change of velocity vector, that is called acceleration. So acceleration vector is denoted by a of t, and it is derivative of v, that is dv by dt, and dv by dt is equal to r double dash of t, that is equal to f double dash of t I plus g double dash of t j plus h double dash of t k. So the velocity vector of the moving particle is given by v of t is equal to r dash of t, and the acceleration vector is given by a of t is equal to r double dash of t. Now let us consider the speed of the moving particle. We know that speed is the magnitude of the velocity vector. So speed is equal to norm of v of t, and we have v of t is equal to this vector. So its norm is equal to root of dx by dt whole square plus dy by dt the whole square plus dz by dt the whole square, where this dx by dt is the same as f dash of t, and dy by dt is g dash of t, and dz by dt is h dash of t. Now in section 9.1 we studied to find the arc length from the time t is equal to t naught to t is equal to t1 of the vector function r of t, and arc length is given by integral t0 to t1 norm of r dash of t dt. And what is r dash of t? R dash of t is equal to the velocity vector v of t. So this becomes integral t0 to t1 norm of v of t dt. So we can define arc length in terms of the velocity vector. Arc length is equal to integral t0 to t1 norm of v of t dt. Now we know the geometrical meaning of r dash of t. Geometrically, the vector r dash of t represents tangent to the curve C at a point. So here we have v of t is equal to r dash of t. So the geometrical meaning of the velocity vector v of t is that it is a tangent to the curve C at some point. So if P x1 y1 z1 is the position vector of the particle on the curve C at some time t1, then velocity vector at the time t1 is the tangent vector to the curve C at the point P. What is P? P is the position vector of the P is the position of the particle on the curve at time t1. Next, let us consider an example to find velocity and acceleration of a moving particle. Consider the question. The position vector of a moving particle is given by r of t is equal to t square I plus tj plus 5 by 2 tk. Find the velocity and acceleration at t is equal to 2. So here we are given the position vector of the moving particle, which is given by this function. We have to find the velocity and acceleration at the time t is equal to 2. So we have r of t is equal to t square I plus tj plus 5 by 2 tk. Its velocity vector is given by the first derivative, that is r dash of t, which is equal to derivative of the first term, derivative of t square is 2t. So we have 2ti plus derivative of t, that is 1. So plus j plus derivative of 5 by 2t, that is 5 by 2. So we have velocity vector is equal to 2ti plus j plus 5 by 2k. Next, the acceleration vector is given by the second derivative, that is r double dash of t. And it is equal to the derivative of this velocity vector. So it is, what is the derivative of the first term? Derivative of 2t, that is equal to 2. So we have 2i plus derivative of j, that is 0. And derivative of the third term also equal to 0. So we have acceleration vector is equal to 2i. And it is a constant vector. Now, velocity at time t, that is v at t, is equal to, in this velocity function, in this velocity vector, in this v of t, we put t is equal to 2. So, v of 2 is equal to, we have v of t is equal to 2ti plus j plus 5 by 2k. So, v of 2 is equal to 4i plus j plus 5 by 2k. Similarly, a of 2, acceleration at time t is equal to 2, is equal to, we have a of t is equal to 2i. So a of 2 also equal to 2i. Now, what is the position vector at t is equal to 2? At t is equal to 2, the position vector is given by r of 2. R of 2 is equal to, in the function r of t, we put t is equal to 2. So we get 4i plus 2j plus 5k. In this function r of t, we put t is equal to 2. So 2 square, that is 4i plus tj, that is 2j plus 5 by 2t. T is equal to 2. So 5 by 2 becomes 5. So this plus 5k. So r of t is equal to 4i plus 2j plus 5k whenever t is equal to 2. So, this is the position vector of the particle at t is equal to 2. So, this means that the particle is at the point 425. The point 425 at the time t is equal to 2. Now, let us find the speed of motion. We know that speed is equal to magnitude of velocity vector. That is equal to, we have v of t is equal to 2ti plus j plus 5 by 2k. So we have norm of the velocity vector is equal to norm of this vector, and it is given by square root of 2t the whole square, that is 4t square plus 1 square, that is 1, plus 5 by 2 square, that is 25 by 4. So this speed is a function of t. So this means that as the time varies, the speed also varies. So here speed is not a constant, because as the time varies, speed also varies. Now let us consider the dot product of velocity vector and acceleration vector. So v of t dot a of t is equal to, we have v of t is equal to 2ti plus j plus 5 by 2k dot a of t. A of t is equal to 2i. So taking the dot product, we get 2t into 2, that is 4t square plus other two terms are zero because here there is no terms containing vector j and vector k. So we have v of t dot a of t is equal to 4t square, and this is zero only when t is equal to zero. If t not equal to zero, this dot product is non-zero. Next, we have a result that if a particle moves with constant speed, then its acceleration vector is perpendicular to the velocity vector v. If a particle moves with a constant speed, then its acceleration vector is perpendicular to the velocity vector v. So here speed is assumed to be constant. We know that speed is equal to magnitude of velocity vector, that is norm of v of t, and it is equal to a constant c. And we know that norm of v the whole square is equal to, since norm of v is equal to c, norm of v the whole square is equal to c square. And we know the relation between dot product and norm. Norm of v the whole square is equal to v dot v. So v dot v is equal to c square. Since c is a constant, c square also is a constant. So we take the derivative on both sides. So LHS becomes d by dt of v dot v, that is equal to derivative of c square, that is d by dt of c square. Since c square is a constant, its derivative is equal to 0. So we have d by dt of v dot v is equal to 0. We know that derivative of dot product of two functions is equal to first function dot derivative of second plus derivative of first dot second. So d by dt of v dot v is equal to v dot dv by dt plus dv by dt dot v, that is equal to 0. We also know that dot product is commutative, that is a dot b is equal to b dot a. So these two values are the same, because that is v dot dv by dt is the same as dv by dt dot v. So since these are same, adding these two we get twice v dot dv by dt, or we can write twice dv by dt dot v. So it is equal to 0. We know that 2 is non-zero, so 2 times v dot dv by dt is equal to 0 implies v dot dv by dt is equal to 0. That is v dot or v of t dot dv by dt is the acceleration vector a of t. So v of t dot a of t is equal to 0. That means we know that if dot product of two vectors is equal to 0, then the vectors are orthogonal. So here vector v and vector a are orthogonal vectors for every t. We consider one more example. Suppose r of t is equal to 2 cos t I plus 2 sin t j plus 3 k represents the position vector of a particle moving in a circular orbit. Then we have to graph the velocity and acceleration vector at t is equal to pi by 4. So we are given the position vector r of t. We have to find the velocity and acceleration. So for this function r of t, the x component is equal to 2 cos t and y component is equal to 2 sin t, z component is equal to 3. So we have x square plus y square. X square plus y square is equal to 4 cos square t plus 4 sin square t, that is equal to 4. So x square plus y square is equal to 4 and z is equal to 3. And this equation represents a circle in the xy plane. Here z is equal to 3. So in the xyz plane, this circle lies 3 units above the xy plane, because here z is equal to 3. We have to find the velocity and acceleration at t is equal to pi by 4. So first of all, we find the position vector at t is equal to pi by 4. That is, in this r of t, in the expression for r of t, we put t is equal to pi by 4. So we get 2 cos pi by 4. We know that cos pi by 4 is equal to 1 by root 2. So 2 into 1 by root 2, that is root 2. So root 2i plus second term 2 sin pi by 4. Sin pi by 4 is equal to 1 by root 2. So 2 into 1 by root 2, again root 2. So this plus root 2j plus 3k. So this is the position vector of the particle at t is equal to pi by 4. It means that at t is equal to pi by 4, the particle lies at the point whose coordinates are root 2, root 2, 3. So at t is equal to pi by 4, the particle is at the point p root 2, root 2, 3. Now we have to find the velocity vector and acceleration vector. Velocity vector v of t is given by r dash of t, that is equal to derivative of r of t, and we know that it is equal to, we have r of t is equal to 2 cos t I plus 2 sin t j plus 3k. So the derivative, we know derivative of cos t is equal to negative sin t. So here negative 2 sin t I plus derivative of sin t is equal to cos t. So this plus 2 cos t j and derivative of constant 3 is equal to 0. So r dash of t is equal to minus 2 sin t I plus 2 cos t j. This is the velocity vector at time t. Similarly, acceleration vector is given by the second derivative r double dash of t, which is equal to, we just differentiate this function. So differentiating, we get negative 2 into derivative of sin t, that is cos t. So minus 2 cos t I plus 2 into derivative of cos t, that is negative sin t. So minus 2 sin t j. So this is the acceleration vector. Now what is the speed? We know that speed is equal to magnitude of velocity vector, and this is the velocity vector. So taking its magnitude, we have square root of negative 2 sin t the whole square, that is 4 sin square t plus similarly square of this term 4 cos square t. So we have square root of 4 sin square t plus 4 cos square t, that is equal to 2. So here speed is a constant. Speed is equal to 2 for all time t. Now since speed is a constant, we prove that acceleration vector is perpendicular to velocity vector. So in this case, speed is equal to 2 is a constant. So a of t is perpendicular to v of t. You can also verify this. You can take the dot product v of t dot a of t or a of t dot v of t. You will get it as 0 because here speed is equal to a constant 2. Now we have to find the velocity vector and acceleration vector at t is equal to pi by 4. So what is v of pi by 4? In the expression for v of t, we just put t is equal to pi by 4. So we get negative 2 sin pi by 4 I plus 2 cos pi by 4 j. That is equal to, we know sin pi by 4 is equal to 1 by root 2. So after cancellation, we get negative root 2 I. Similarly, cos pi by 4 is equal to 1 by root 2. So 2 by root 2, that is again root 2. So this plus root 2 j. So v of pi by 4 is equal to negative root 2 I plus root 2 j. Similarly, a of pi by 4 is equal to, what is a of t? Negative 2 cos t I minus 2 sin t j. So a of pi by 4 is equal to negative 2 cos pi by 4 I minus 2 sin pi by 4 j. That is equal to, again substituting for cos pi by 4 and sin pi by 4 and cancelling, we get negative root 2 I minus root 2 j. So these are velocity and acceleration vectors. Now this is the graph of the given vector function. After taking parametric equations, we got the Cartesian equation that x square plus y square is equal to 4 and z is equal to 3. And x square plus y square is equal to 4 represents a circle of center origin and radius 2. Since z is equal to 3, this circle lies 3 units above the above this plane, above the XY plane. So this circle marked as red, this is our curve C. Now we have to draw the graph of V of pi by 4 and A of pi by 4. We know that velocity vector at a point means tangent to the vector. Here at t is equal to pi by 4, we got that the position vector is root 2 I plus root 2 j plus 3k. Correspondingly, its point is P root 2 root 2 3, and it is marked here, and in at this point we draw a tangent. And similarly, the acceleration vector is perpendicular to velocity vector. So this is the acceleration vector A of pi by 4, and this is the velocity vector V of pi by 4. With this, I conclude my class. Thank you.